Arpital Space. Today I'm going to show you some of the places to visit and things to do in and around Bentota, Sri Lanka. Bentota is a coastal town in Sri Lanka, located in Gaul district of the southern province. It is approximately 65 kilometers south of Colombo and 56 kilometers north of Gaul. We stayed at Shinagawa Beach Hotel in Balapitiya, which is another coastal town in southern province. It took us around 2 hours to reach here by road from Colombo via a cab. This costed us around 7,000 or 8,000. Started in 2014, this hotel is a nice escape from the hustling city lives most of us juggle with. It offers an outdoor pool and a private beach. I'll cover this place in detail in my upcoming videos, so stay tuned. For now, let's get started and see from my lens the iconic places we visited in Bentota. We had a packed day to look forward to, wherein we had planned to visit quite a few famous places for which we had pre-booked a cab. We started our day almost in the middle of the night since we had to leave for Mirissa at 4 a.m. for, as exciting as it sounds, whale watching. I know how painful and unrealistic waking up at 3 in the morning sounds, that too on a vacation. But when I retrospect this day, I feel it was totally worth it for the experiences this day offered us with. Whale and dolphin watching in Mirissa is one of the most exciting water activities you can do during your holiday in Sri Lanka. Whale watching season in Mirissa is from November to April. Sometimes turtles and flying fishes can also be spotted here. Different kinds of whales can be seen, though blue whale is the most common sight. This trip usually takes 3 to 5 hours. Tours generally start before 7 a.m. from the Mirissa Harbour. Morning tea, breakfast, snacks and water are served during the tour. The boats vary a lot in terms of upkeep, and I would recommend that you check with a local as to how to go about getting a decent boat. I would recommend you to do your research before booking the whale watching package, since the costs for these rides fluctuate between 5,000 to 10,000 LKR per person or even more. This looks so empty since everyone was outside on a lookout for whales. They also rely on phone calls from local fishermen and other boats to zone the area. And that's our Captain Cool with all his gears. Sun-kissed water all around, glistening in gold. Can it get any better? Such a sight it was already in itself, and to add to the glory, we saw the Queen of the Sea, the mighty whale. Oh boy, it was a spectacular sight beyond words. So taking back the memories of this experience of a lifetime, we reached the port back by 11 and then headed towards our next destination, the Gaul Dutch Fort. Gaul Fort was built by the Portuguese, enlarged by the Dutch, and modified by the Britishers. It is a UNESCO World Heritage Site. It is a must-visit place for all the history lovers out there. One can explore more about Sri Lanka's culture and tradition at this amazing fort. Located about 50 kilometers on the south of Bentota, this fort is stretched across 87 acres of land. It is home to a huge collection of antique museums and archaic churches. I learned that many art and literary festivals are organized at this fort. Since the weather here is mostly hot, I recommend to choose evenings or mornings rather than noontime to explore this place, especially for strolling in the open. I learned that there are three museums here: the Marine Archaeology Museum, National Museum, and Mansions Private Museum. The wonderful sea views surrounding this place make up for excellent photo backgrounds. There is a small town-like place built within the fort, comprising of lots of little boutique shops to browse around. There one can shop for local jewelry, clothes, and souvenirs. There are bars as well to enjoy some cool drinks. Apart from this, some of the other highlights of this place are the clock tower, the lighthouse, and an adjacent cricket ground. Caught up in capturing every bit of this place in my camera that I hardly shot myself. I do have a few snaps of myself here, so here I am in my touristy avatar. Next on our list were the cinnamon gardens, but owing to extremely hot weather, we had to give it a miss. We then headed to the turtle hatchery as suggested by our cab driver, since it was a covered area, thus would not be so hot. Here we saw a wide variety of fishes and turtles, most of which were rescued by the caretakers of this place. Especially for the nature lovers, this spot is considered as the most enchanting places to visit in Bentota. These are turtle eggs, and this is the actual size of one of their species. I never knew they can be so big. Abir was specially very happy and excited, and equally scared to be here. The turtles brought here were wounded or rendered handicapped due to fishing, attack by a predator, or due to contamination of the sea, especially with plastic bags, which ultimately gets consumed by the sea creatures. The fact that we humans have made their lives so miserable makes me very sad, and I pledge to minimize the use of plastic. After leaving from here, we were tired, hungry, sleepy, all at the same time. We tried exploring some restaurants on the way in Gaul, but again, finding something vegetarian was a challenge. So we headed back to our hotel, ate, spent the evening by the beach, and called it a day early. So So that's it for this video, guys. Bye-bye, and do like, comment, share, and subscribe. Happy living and healthy living.